Hello, welcome to FX Bootcamp. My name is Jarius Jenkins and this is your Tokyo session video briefing. What follows is the live wrap-up of the major item or items we covered during the session at fxbootcamp.com. Today during the Asian session, we only had about two setups that were worth taking a look at. One of them was a news-based setup and the other one was just price action-based. They both resulted in, on the long term, a very good trade, but during the Asian session they both had very different outcomes. The first thing we'll take a quick look at is the news setup that we had on the USDJPY. When the news came out, we had a monetary base and capital spending coming out of Japan, and when the news came out, price spiked up. Initially it spiked up from 122.04 to 122.09, a 5 pip spike. Now this immediately made me feel as though we should exercise caution in thinking about any trade on this, as the news over 5 minutes was only able to move the price about 5 pips. We want to see a sustained move or something that looks sustainable on a news move, and this did not look to be sustainable. Right after the initial 5 minutes of the spike, price shot down the opposite direction. You may have gotten in on this on a break of the support level, but looking at price action, let's take a look at it from this viewpoint. All indications up until that time were for price to be heading up on the yen. The 200 was up, the 55 was up, the 21 was up, even though price was bouncing between the 21 and the 55. And you might anticipate that if it's bouncing on the 55, you might take a drop down to the 200, but based on the speed at which price was moving, we weren't very excited about any type of motion or any type of action on this news during the Asian session. So if you had taken a break of the level of support, that would have put you in at about 122.02 or 03. Fast forward price action, we see that it made a spike down to 92. Before retracing back up to your entry point and down again to 92, then to 90, and back up to the 200, and at about 12 o'clock, which is when our Asian session is over, we were at 92 and we made a trip back to the 200. Later on in the day, price continued to fall, but based on the initially slow reaction of price at the time of news, we were not very excited about this move in general. It did provide us with an overall trend, as the numbers were generally better for generally good for the yen. So as time went on, we went up above the initial news price, and later in the day, better seen on the 15-minute chart, later in the day, price proved to want to go down, but there were much better entry points later on in the day to get in on that downwards movement than that initial news move. The move that we would focus more on today would be the pound move. Switching to the pound chart, we see the price opened up and right before we started our session, price started moving down. Price made a low, and as you can see, we were looking at the 21, the 55, and the 200 all pointing up. We were expecting that price might move up for the day, so we were looking for an upswing on this move. What happened? Price spiked up and proved as though it wanted to move during our session. It had a bigger move during our session than the yen did after its news. Price went from 16 to 32, about 16 pip move. So we were a bit excited about this move. We were looking for reasons to get in. We saw that we traded this somewhat like a news move, and we're looking for a break of the level of resistance that we could have drawn. We got that. and we may have been in on a trade. Now, while this was happening, the euro was doing nothing and the Swissie was not supporting the movement either. So this was just the pound making a move. As we watch price, one of the things that I cautioned people on was to determine what would keep them in the trade, what would get them out of a trade. If they were looking for the standard stock answer of a 5-8 cross gets me out of the trade, then we had a 5-8 cross here, which would have gotten you out of the trade. Now, if you got in at 23, then your exit would have been at around the 20 level minus spread. So you'd have been in for a small loss. If you stayed with the trade, then you'd have gone up a bit. And across the rest of the day, price action would have taken you up well over 100 pips on the move. This is an important trade to look at, as it's one that where we must question, what is it that gets us in or out? Do we allow stops to get us in or out? Do we allow 5-8s to take us out? Do we have a trade plan that says stay in the trade until we're profitable and then allow the 5-8 to get us out of a trade? If we allow the 5-8 to get us out of a trade that's profitable, maybe we get out at this point in time or over here. We would have set specific targets for the day, but that's not the point of this review at the moment. The point is, how do you determine when you're going to how long you'll stay in a trade that's not necessarily going for you, not necessarily going against you, but not going in your direction? One person may have put their stop below the 55 and trailed their stop up. Another person may have put their stop below the 55 initially and decided to get in when the 5-8 crossed. Again, there's no stock answer. You have to take each day as it comes and make a decision based on the action of the day. If you had overlaid the idea that the US dollar was most likely going to see weakness due to the price action after NFP, maybe your threshold would have been waiting for the price action to take out your stop instead of waiting for 5-8 to cross. If that was the case, maybe you stayed in a bit longer than if your usual answer is to wait for the 5-8 to cross against you to the downside. So in this case, we cautioned people that they needed to decide what was it that was going to be important to them, 5-8 crosses, stops being taken out, or whatever. And if they had made the right decision, then there was well over 100 pips worth of movement for them to take part of. If not, then they only had a minimum gain to small loss, which is also not too bad. That's it for today's review of the Tokyo session at FX Bootcamp. I'm Jarius Jenkins.